It used to be when I was thinking that carbs were like the big enemy, but I've learned a lot in nutrition over the last few years. And so now I just try to keep it, I try to be very smart about when I eat my carbs and what kind of carbs I eat.
The name Jen Thompson has become synonymous with a strong bench press.
Bro, you totally just Jen Thompson that 95 pounder.
Basically triple figures. Right now it's actually her squat that graces the top of the IPF's records page. And this 132 pound athlete is indeed very talented at all of the big three in powerlifting. She actually held the 63 kilo total world record in the IPF for a while with 486 kilos or a little over 1,071 pounds. And again, this is at roughly 138 pounds body weight and in her mid 40s as well. But her bench press, Jen Thompson's bench press is prodigious. As a 63 kilo lifter, she has the IPF world record bench press of 142.5 kilos and the bench only record of 144 kilos and the official American and unofficial world record of 145 kilos. Also, once she turned up to a meet a little bit heavy at 63.15 kilos, so she had to compete as a 72 kilo athlete, and then she set a world record then with 144 kilos. That was 3 years ago. It still hasn't been broken. So of course it was a no-brainer to include Jen Thompson in our series of interviews on what world-class athletes eat. If you don't know how she works out, we've got plenty of articles on that on barbend.com. I've put some links in the description below. But as for what she eats, she actually puts quite a lot of thought into it. So she's 5'5 in her height. Her weight is 132 to 140 pounds throughout the year. That's where she hovers. She was 138 pounds when I spoke to her. She works out about 4 times a week. So it's 2 days in a row and then 2 days off. So what are our calories and macros?
Mostly I eat, it depends on if it's a leg day, if it's an upper body day, or if it's a rest day. On leg days, I get around 2,000. If it's an upper body, I get about 1,500. And if it's a rest day, I get more like 1,200.
Leg days and deadlift days, as you may have experienced for yourself, can sometimes be a bit more metabolically demanding than upper body days or bench press days. I would not have said that to someone who holds multiple bench press world records, but nonetheless, Jen agrees with that. She eats more calories on like leg days and more full body workout days. So calories are nice though, but what about macros? And by macros, I mean protein. Let's talk about protein. How much protein does she eat?
In general, I only get 160 grams of protein in a day. That never changes. The only thing that really changes is my carbs. Like on a leg day, I'll get up near 180, but like on a rest day, I'll keep it under 100. Fat is usually between 50 and 60 grams.
So even for an athlete, that's pretty high in protein. Most athletes, they tend to aim for about 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight. What Jen's eating here is actually close to 1.2 grams per pound of body weight. And actually, she would like to eat more than that. Her real goal is 200 grams per day. She just never really meets it.
I end up probably getting more realistically, I get around 160.
Now, her calories and macros naturally change depending on where she is throughout her strength cycle and what weight she's trying to achieve. But she doesn't actually track her calories and macros every single day. In her own words, that's an easy way to go insane. So what she does is she'll like kind of check in and track her diet, track her calories and macros for a week or so every now and then throughout the cycle just to see where she's at and what needs to be changed.
Mostly I start tracking, well, in the beginning of my training, I usually try to do like a 12-week training cycle. So in the beginning, I'm not too worried about my diet. I want to stay heavy and really work on building some strength. But then as I'm getting closer to the competition dates, when I'm really starting to focus on my macros, which is probably about 8 weeks out, I'll start tracking a little bit about 8 weeks out just to kind of see where I'm at, if I'm getting near my macros, just kind of check them. And I'll do it for probably like a week straight because mostly it just gets me motivated to get my diet in dialed correctly. And so I'll do that for about a week and then I'll just do it periodically as I get closer to the meet. I'll just do it maybe once a week or so just to make sure that I'm where I think I am.
Typically over those 12 weeks, she'll have about 7 or so pounds to lose, which she was at pains to insist is actually quite a lot of weight for someone who weighs under 140 pounds.
You know, I know only sounds like 7 pounds, but on my frame, it's a lot. 7 pounds feels like so much more than it probably does for most people.
So during that weight loss process, in addition to gradually tapering her calories down, she'll also cut her carbohydrates about in half. So at the beginning of the process, she'll be eating about 160 grams of protein and 200 grams of carbohydrates. And by the end of it, toward competition time, it'll be more like 160 grams of protein and 100 grams of carbohydrates. But what does she eat? Well, Jen Thompson is a creature of habit and she tends to eat a lot of the same foods over and over again. So if you are in the market for completely stealing everything Jen Thompson eats, I don't know how legal that is, but she's made it very, very easy for you in this next section. Here's what she eats almost every day.
So my morning, I always start off with a vanilla whey protein drink with almond milk. I have that every single morning. And then I have a Power Crunch bar or an RX No BS bar for a morning snack. That never changes. Like every single day, it's the same. Then for lunch, I usually make an omelet, have some sort of eggs. And if it's like a leg day, I'll throw in some like whole wheat or whole grain toast with that.
And now we get into supplements. Jen Thompson's friend and also a fellow bench press monster, Dennis Cherry, actually started his own line of supplements called SSP Nutrition. And they kind of like take over around training.
Well, I use the SSP Nutrition. So I have their lean muscle protein shake in the afternoon before workout. Then I have their pre before my workout, their post after my workout. And then I usually have like a high protein dinner. I'll grill up chicken and put on a salad, or we eat a lot of bison at our house. So I'll do bison burgers or bison tacos or bison spaghetti.
Bison.
And it really doesn't change like a whole lot. And then I always end my day with a cup of hot tea and a square of dark chocolate. The only other thing I focus on is eating a lot of veggies, because I just think those are like, they're the key, is eating veggies. They're just so good for you. I love broccoli. I love the kale. And I just like making like just a nice masculine salad with like pumpkin seeds and some dried cranberries on there, a little poppy seed dressing. I can eat that like four meals a day. It's so good. Yeah, I used to eat veggies just with dinner. And so now I'm making sure I'm getting at least two. I try three other times a day to get just something, whether it's just some, I'll cut up bell peppers and I'll put them in the refrigerator just so I can grab and snack on them if I just want something crunchy, carrots, celery, stuff like that. I'll just throw it in there so I can just easily grab it and chew on a few. And then I feel better about myself because I'm meeting my goal.
All right, so you got your calories, you got your macros, you got your standard meals, and you got most of the supplements here as well. The pre-workout, by the way, is mostly branched chain amino acids with some beta-alanine and citrulline and caffeine. You can learn all about these very basic staple pre-workout ingredients in my guide to them right there. The post-workout is mostly whey protein and carbohydrates with some antioxidants to help beat inflammation. There's a bit more to them than that, but these are like the broad strokes here. Like these are the main ingredients in these supplements. And these are most of the supplements that she takes. But she also takes what she calls, and what we would never call, old lady supplements.
Like it's old lady stuff. Iron, calcium, vitamin D. You just need more of that as you get older. So I do that kind of supplement stuff. I tried fish oils for a while, but I just didn't like the way it made me feel, and it was just gross. So I don't do it. I feel like, you know, with what I'm doing now, I don't really feel like I need to make any improvements with my nutrition. I go into my workouts with lots of energy, ready to go. And then I power, my workouts are really long. We end up working out for about 2 hours. It's all 100% intensity all the time. And I'm able to be excited about my workout, start my workout, and then power through my workout all the way to the end.
Finally, Jen did have a couple of tips for alcohol and for eating out. She will sometimes work some wine into her carbohydrate count, but she will tend to cut it out as a competition approaches.
It tends to mess with your sleep a little bit, makes you feel a little dried out.
And when you're eating out, but you've got a diet you've got to stick to, this is her advice.
Like I find when you go out and eat, there's always a good option if you look for it. It may not be the one you want when you're looking at all those other wonderful options, but there's always, you know, a good option.
All right, I think that's just about the answer to every single question you could have possibly had about Jen Thompson's diet. This one was pretty exhaustive, but pretty informative. I think there's a lot of really actionable tips here for the average athlete and the elite athlete. I really want to thank Jen Thompson for coming on the channel today. You can check out her Instagram handle in the description below and on the screen right now. And make sure you subscribe as well, because we've got a whole lot more nutrition videos and fitness content coming up.